Hello, welcome to the video for what is material, the append vector node. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up our quick little example here, and we have our append node here. Now our append node is pretty simple. We're going to have two inputs and we're going to have one output. We have no material parameters. So what's the append node used for? Well, it's pretty simple. Basically, it's going to append one value onto the back end of another value. So for example, a standard texture, let's pull this up, might have an R, a G, and a B value. Or if it was a 4, it's an R, G, B, A value. Now let's say, for example, we only had two of those values and we wanted to add a third. Maybe we had an X and a Y, and we had a node that needed a X, Y, Z. Well, you can use an append vector for that. You would input your X and Y and add the Z. So for example, we have our append node here. Now if I was to take our append node, and let's just plug it straight into our missive color, and we hit apply, we're going to get an error. You're going to need at least an A and a B, or it's not going to work. So let's hook up our A and our B, which is set to 0 right now. And we're going to get back a 0. I am giving in my emissive color a value of 0, 0, 0. Let's change this to a 1. Now what we should expect and what we're going to get is a red. What we're doing is we're giving a 1, 0, 1 into our emissive. A red, 1, 0, 0, sorry. Red, green, blue. So a value of 1 for red, 0 for green, and 0 for blue. Let's pipe this into our other append for our example and put another 0 here. And you can see as I add it together what happens. So right here we have a 1, 0, 0 going into emissive. We change this to a 1, we're going to have a 1, 1, 0, or we get yellow. We put 1 in our last value, we get a red, green, blue of 1, 1, 1, which is white. So for example, if it was just green, it would be a 0 and a 0, and we're going to end up with just green. The append, again, appends one number, which is our B value, onto the back end of our A value. So in this case, red of 0 and green of 1. So for an example to further illustrate this, I made this one example up here with some actual textures. And let's actually unhook our bottom one. Let's set this to a 0 to make it easier to see. So here we go. Right here in our red input, we are putting in this brick texture that you can see here. So you can actually see we have in our red channel a brick texture. Anywhere there was white, we're going to end up with red. Anywhere there was black, we're going to end up with black. We're going to end up with no red value. On top of this, we are appending this noise texture into our green channel. And that's why we're getting this green noise. Anywhere there was white in our texture is going to be output as green. Anywhere there was black is going to be output as nothing or black. That's why you're getting this little transparent mask here, because we're basically stacking textures on top of each other in a red, green, blue channel. And then when I added this one right here, whoops, not, you don't want to do the three colors. This is one of those issues. These are single channels. This does not want a three channel value. It wants a single channel. So that's why I'm outputting just my red channel, just my red channel, and just my red channel. And for my example, if I was to pull up this and look at just the red channel, just to show you how it's working, my red channel is basically just going to be a black and white mask. So I'm basically outputting, I am outputting one color, a black and white mask here, a black and white mask here, and a black and white mask here, saying use this one for red, use this one for green, use this one for blue, and that's why we get this really funky amalgamation here. And of course, the reason this is purple is because we have some white values in the red, and some white values in the green, and some white values in the blue, which of course is all going to combine into this purple. And then where there was black, which is an absence of color, or zero, we're going to get it seen through completely. Just the white from the red, just the white from the green. So that's what our append node is for. It's useful for doing work on a single channel. Maybe you want to do some multiplication or math or some adjustments on this channel, and then append it after you do some operations to it. And allows you to build something together. So that's it. That's what our append node is for. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below.